Hello everyone, it's the Shaded Tank Clan.
We're here to Star Wars Force Awakens in the theater for the first time!
It was awesome.
You're Black you guys... 0514.
Anyway, it starts! Dude, take the helmet off because it'll be hard for anybody else to understand it. Nobody in the video would understand what you're saying.
Dude,
okay,
if you're gonna at least do that,
they can
on.
A little bit. We tested out earlier.
Put the hood on.
No, we did.
Alright, so over here we have Black Shadow 0514, Sister Jess, and here we have
Jesse, I'm the guest.
And George, aka Goldtank GWF, you guys know me. Basically,
the idiots.
We just finished seeing Star Wars The Force Awakens, and it was so good. We absolutely loved it. It's slick. Like, some of us even think it's the best Star Wars, which would be me. Then they still think that Episode 5 is better. Alright, so what do you guys have to say about the movie? I'll let you guys go first.
Darth Vader, be my guest. Go for it.
Alright, here's the thing about Force Awakens. I must say, like, sitting down in that theater and having that opening crawl roll across the screen really is unlike any other movie I've ever experienced in my life. Ever. And it's like, it's weird because it's like you feel like you've been waiting forever to see the movie, and that feels like it's there too quickly. You're like, Lucasfilm Ltd., Star Wars, slow down. But then after you read the opening crawl, you feel at home. You really do. And I think, personally, I think that this was actually the best opening scene out of the whole saga and pretty much any movie.
Well, the problem thing is, it's all nostalgia. All of us have seen the movie more than 30 times. And when this is the first time any of us ever seen it in theaters.
Right. Yeah.
You guys ever seen it in theaters?
No. And boys,
before I forget,
should we, no spoilers?
Yeah,
no spoilers. Okay, no spoilers. Before we get any more to the video.
Yeah.
I'm just saying, best opening scene of all time.
Yeah, but still, it's mostly nostalgia.
There is a lot of nostalgia, that's for sure, yeah.
A lot of nostalgia.
Anyway, in this episode, there's lots of things that are common themes within the whole saga of Star Wars.
And also a lot of callbacks.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, there are a lot of good references and laughs. For
anyone that is expecting to see it, expect classic themes of revenge, betrayal,
and punch you in the face of stuff.
Yeah. And there's lots of different things that should not be mentioned, but are very much worth watching.
I'm gonna give one spoiler. Stormtroopers can hit now.
Oh, come on.
That's not really much of a spoiler.
Stormtroopers.
That's one satisfying thing.
Stormtroopers are mad ass, man. It's like, these guys have been through some serious target practice.
Yeah.
Well, they're not the Empire. They're not the Empire Stormtroopers anymore.
Not Imperial Stormtroopers now.
Yeah. Does
it make you proud, Vader?
Yes, it makes me proud.
So, what would you guys rate it out of 10?
Compared to movies, or is that 10?
Just like out of 10, on how much you liked it.
I'll have to put a high 8, low 9.
Alright, Jacob, aka Sister Jess.
Oh, 10. That's because, like, I have a bad, like, rating system. Like, if I like a movie, it's automatic 10. I can't vote for shit or like rate anything in my life.
Yeah, I agree with that. But still,
screw you too, asshole.
Alright, and Black Shadow. Black Shadow.
Well, this rating is probably going to change with multiple viewings as it's a really tear apart this film. But initially, I'm just going to go ahead and put this at let's call it a 9.3. 9.3.
How did I know?
I'd have to put it personally at a 9.8, although it is probably my favorite movie that I've seen ever.
Well, what would you say? Like, you are like 10 with room to decrease with multiple viewings?
No.
What is yours? Like, the.
Mine does not decrease.
I had a little bit of a problem, like, in the movie theaters, and it kind of ruined, like, the last half an hour. But when I watch it again, I can roll completely relaxed through
it. Yeah, really is, like, the second time you watch the movie, like, any movie, I think, tends to be, the best experience for me personally.
Yeah.
Because you actually get to enjoy it.
I enjoyed this.
It's a different type of enjoyment.
Yeah.
Like right now, it feels hard to like say anything bad about this film just because waited so long and now we finally have it.
Yeah.
So it's hard
yeah.
to tear it down like on the first day. But with multiple viewings and when we like start doing some real comparisons, it's got room to drop. I think.
Movies don't drop. Like I'm really bad at rating.
Because you wanted me here.
The one complaint that I do have at the movie, it's not spoiler.
No spoilers.
It's not about a character or anything, but the video images of the asteroid belt. When I saw it, it looked more flat, like a piece of paper, and asteroids were all floating in it. Instead of it all being spread out more, it was just like a thin line of asteroids placed randomly.
The show was like
a good more, dude.
I would have liked it better if there were more and it was less organized because it just looked way too organized.
Do you know how space works? Then how can you complain about it?
He's
comparing like the alignment of asteroids. Have you seen the alignment of asteroids?
In terms of visuals, would you say that the visuals, how would you say the blend between practical effects and CGI was? How do you think the balance was, like on a scale of 1 to 10?
It was actually pretty good. It was actually hard to tell CGI characters from puppets or actors. But we can all agree that Chewbacca was 100% actor. There was no CGI in him.
Yeah.
Especially like scenery and like
Chewbacca definitely looked a bit taller than he did in the other movies.
Yeah.
In my opinion,
I'm pretty sure he was taller in this one.
Yeah, because Harrison Ford is like around 6 foot, I think.
Yeah,
and Chewbacca is definitely at least 2 feet taller.
Yeah,
which is just crazy.
And in Jedi, Han Solo to Chewbacca's like. Collarbone, like right
yeah.
here. And in this one, he really went up to his chest.
Yeah.
So, yeah, Chewbacca was a hell of a lot taller.
Yeah.
I'd say for that, the whole blend between like special effects and practical effects and CGI, I really don't think it could have been better. Like, in that category, I'd have to give it a 10. Like, it was, have that, I kind of like to compare it to, like, when you think about how, what the balance is in, like, Lord of the Rings, where it feels like just that right amount. Like it's got that old school retro feel of like practical effects from the original trilogy, but it didn't go overboard with like CGI like the prequels obviously did.
Yeah,
they definitely got that right. Good picture.
I can agree.
My best picture I've seen this year.
I definitely agree on that.
Mm-hmm. What about you, Sister Jess?
Yeah,
you're a CGI guy, aren't you?
I don't know. You're probably still playing it out more, but
it was good. It looked good. I liked it. I enjoyed it.
Any really part of the animation where you didn't like it?
The one thing that the theater did that I would have liked better is they didn't give us the Star Wars 3D glasses. They should have.
Dude, that's a viable thing. They're in the concession stand, so you can just buy them.
Tell us what the hell.
I saw them when we were leaving.
I saw them as I was walking out. I figure I'm gonna see it like again. Oh, wait, what?
Glasses. Apparently, they were at the concession.
Yeah, I saw them. You guys didn't see them?
What? I saw them.
Afterwards.
I wanted one.
Yeah, I saw
I wanted a Zoom trooper.
Boy, afterwards.
Yeah.
I saw him afterwards. But
damn it, dude.
This is still, even though it's Star Wars, I wouldn't buy it. Like, personally, I wouldn't.
I would.
I mean, I already just watched to have it. I'm going to want to keep the ones that I actually watched the movie with. And that's,
yeah, I'm going to keep over there. Those two.
Yeah.
That's in here.
Yeah. Oh, funny story. Well, I was at the theater. Apparently, I don't know what happened to my ticket after I was already sitting down. It may have fallen into my popcorn box, and I may have eaten it.
You've done the impossible.
I don't know how I may.
George, you've done the impossible. You've made Darth Vader like cry.
Okay, first, so
anyway, hopefully
how did you not notice they were eating paper?
I was just shoveling my mouth with popcorn.
Dude, he was dunking his head in. He was just like,
you ate like 10% of them before the movie even started.
Actually, almost half.
Yeah.
And then
you had to eat 10% before the screen turned on.
Yeah.
He ate a whole big carton by himself.
Yeah, it was good.
What do you guys think about the First Order? How do you like it? How do you like the new, This new age and galactic imperialism.
I think
they were actually more competent this time around.
Yeah,
they could actually fight.
They actually trained the stormtroopers from birth.
This was part of the aspect of the film I was looking for the best to see.
Some of them were clones, anyways. Some of them were clones, anyways. So
yeah, there might still be some clones surviving. From the Clone Wars. I don't know. Could be, could not be.
This First Order was like a. It finally felt like they cleaned up like the overly cleanliness they had towards like the heroes. Like so one thing about the original trilogy that just bugged the hell out of me is that they are the luckiest people ever. Like, everything seems to bounce their way at every turn, and there's not a whole lot of upsets. I mean, there are at times, but it's like, for the most part, anytime they're pursued by any sort of Imperial, the Imperials have, like, really no chance whatsoever.
Honestly, dude.
That's the original trilogy. Are you
jealous?
Yeah, most of the original trilogy, they were actually not very competent at all. Like,
the
Empire, they actually destroyed one of their own Star Destroyers when they're following the Falcon.
Yeah.
And this one, they really didn't kill each other in accident at all.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah, this was,
they just killed with their own weapons.
That dark sun down.
Yeah, I mean, the ships, the troops, all looks awesome, man.
Yeah.
I'd say it's definitely one thing that was improved upon from the original trilogy. But then again, it's like, now you figure this First Order is actually, like, at war and not so much...
Yeah.
As nice as they were. It's like in the original trilogy, your basic policy is arrest and interrogate, don't really kill for the most part.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, the First Order, they're treated more like Nazis.
Yeah.
Like, they acted like it, and they looked like
they did,
it too.
Yeah, they did.
In the one speech scene, she actually the flags. Well, it's in the trailer, so sorry.
It's in the trailer, yeah.
Yeah.
Make sure.
Yeah, it's in the trailer.
One of the best.
You see the flags scattered all over the place, and all the troops all stand together. This looks like a giant Nazi thing.
It really does, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's
something like it too.
That's something I noticed going into this. And, I think that's a pretty good idea. Like, that seems like the Empire always should have been like that. It seems
They should
have
been truly evil.
Yeah, because it's like the original trilogy, they left too much room for people like me who are going to come along and say, well, the Empire, I mean, they were... We think about it, they really were for law and order. I mean, they abolished chaos and, you know, only the few suffer so long as, you know, pay your taxes and register your business. But now it seems like they're real, really going the distance with the fact that they are evil, you will deal.
Yeah.
Yeah, I definitely agree.
Yeah, yeah.
Right. So,
we agree with some things, that the character designs were actually a lot better.
Yeah.
And, like, they have to look good. Like, they're more just, like, old and bad.
Yeah, and for once, the evil characters didn't look, like, as evil as you would think that they would be.
What do you mean by that?
I'm not gonna spoil. I'm not gonna put any names or anything, but
she's not gonna
remember them. People are people, and whether you're on the good side or the bad side, people on the good side can look like terrible people, but people on the bad side can easily look like good people, and I think it's a good balance that this episode has definitely reached.
I kind of see what you mean a little bit. There's like the every single Imperial baddie tends to be like more of the, you know, it's like
throwing words out there.
So disturbing looking. I mean,
bananas, lightsaber,
like Darth Vader. The Emperor. Go back to the prequels. You know, General Grievous. Federation dudes. I mean, they all like really
looked evil.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Well, this.
They looked evil, but it's the thing with the New Order. They didn't necessarily. They did look evil, but it's like they acted evil.
They acted
evil.
Yeah.
The prequels, they just looked evil.
Like the whole sexism.
And all the characters too.
Yeah.
All the Geonosians, Grievous, Dooku.
This thing really does make the prequels look like a joke. It's ridiculous.
Yeah.
It feels like, to me, it kind of feels like this movie is like 10 years overdue. Like, if we had just gone in this, like, the forward direction to begin with.
Yeah.
I don't know.
If this replaced Phantom Menace, the prequels would have gone a lot better. And they would have actually been liked by anybody.
I'm really curious to see how this movie does, like, with the
box office, yeah. Alright, so what was your guys' opinion on the lightsaber shape, the new lightsaber shape, anyway?
I'm okay with it.
I keep telling these guys that the Sith, they use synthetic crystals for the lightsabers.
Yeah.
So they're not actually real, and they're imbued with the dark side of the Force.
Yeah.
Makes them stronger. And if you compare the good character's lightsaber to the Sith character. The Sith character's lightsaber looks like it actually came out of the blaster rifle.
Yeah.
It looks like a giant lightning bolt.
It looks like pure energy rather than a solid form that the traditional
It doesn't look like a solid block of light energy.
Yeah.
It just looks like an unstable version of a lightsaber is about to explode.
Yeah.
That's what it looks like.
Yeah. Well, the shape where it had the crossbar, I think that was a good touch for the most part, but a good character, I don't think, could pull off that same type of lightsaber.
I can go with
the guard, because
it's kind of like a guard, yeah.
It pretty much is, but you have, it doesn't...
There's a
gap where a lightsaber can go between it and slide straight through it.
Yeah, I've never seen it somewhere. It's like,
if the lasers split right where the sword comes out, then it wouldn't be much of a design flaw.
It is a design flaw. I think and it may come back to, by Kylo Ren in the ass, but,
That's the name? I can't remember it.
No, I mean, spoiler.
The name is
One thing I wonder is if in the next episode they're going to bring back evil characters having a different colored lightsaber than just red. Because
That's never going to happen.
That's not going to happen.
It's tradition.
That was a Legends thing.
The only characters that had a different colored lightsaber was Grievous.
He had
stolen the lightsabers from
Jedi. Yeah, I guess so. And he didn't really have control of the Force because he was mostly not human.
Yeah, he wasn't human at all. He was more of an cyborg, but a robot. And no Force at all.
Robots for the win.
Anything else?
How's the soundtrack? The classic.
Yeah. Pretty classic.
That's some original
stuff in there. It goes back to the original series. Like, a lot of music from the original series is in this movie.
Yeah, I think there was some new like soundtracks, I think, at times. But they definitely did reinsert a lot of the more classic melodies from, you know, the old days. I'd say I was happy with the score.
Yeah,
it was good stuff. But that picture, though,
it looked amazing.
It
looked awesome.
Especially since we saw it in...
Just enough.
Yeah.
Not too much, not too little. So yeah, it's just perfect balance, practical effects.
Especially since we saw it in 3D. I think 3D was used really well in this movie.
Yeah, we'll see this in IMAX.
Well, we did see it in IMAX 3D. So it was a lot better than normal theaters.
Yeah.
We saw it in Extreme XD.
Yeah. Same thing. I don't know.
Don't pressure check if he's
really
getting into this conversation.
Yeah, so...
What's up? I would say I was a little jittery while we were waiting to get
You calmed down in the seats. So we actually got our seats.
That was weird.
Yeah, you calmed down.
Jacob
and then I started
so
getting jittery.
I
started freaking out, and then you just like were calm.
I was calm as soon as I sat down in my seat. And then Jacob started freaking out. That's what Jacob like started yelling at me.
Of all people were expected to be like jittery, it should have been me, but it wasn't at all. Because
you were eating your popcorn, you had your mouth full.
Yeah, you're getting your hands full.
Yeah.
I've been jittery since this morning. Before even when I woke up, I was actually hitting my legs because I was so excited.
I actually
probably have bruises.
Yeah, I woke
legs
up like at like 4:50 something. Been awake that whole time, went back to sleep, went to the theater, was perfectly calm, steps inside, starts walking. Starts shaking. Just like, hey guys, you wanna play a game? Wanna play some games? We calm nerves, man.
I mean, it's like you're trying to sell us drugs.
Hey, what's good?
Now.
Listen, we get old.
Long story short. Good movie. Go see it.
Yeah.
Don't do drugs.
Don't do drugs.
Okay, let's just finish this up.
You have an objection to that? Don't do drugs.
Well, let's just finish
this
up.
No, that's what I'm saying.
I'm not sure
if you're
a fucking fool.
Shut up, guys. We're finishing this up now, okay?
Signing off.
Alright, signing off from Shaded Tank.
Hey, guys.
Alright, bye.